Good morning, praise the Lord. Today, November 6th, we'll talk about the 25th book of the New Testament, third letter of John. Third John 11 says, "He who does good is of God, but he who does evil has not seen God at all." Like the second letter, this also has one chapter only. You must have noticed it. In 1 John, the apostle discusses fellowship with God. In 2 John, he forbids fellowship with false teachers. And in 3 John, he encourages fellowship with Christian brothers. Following his expression of love for Gaius, John voices his joy that Gaius is persistently walking in the truth and showing hospitality to the messengers of the gospel. But John cannot commend certain others in the assembly. Diotrephes, for example, has allowed pride to replace love in his life, even rejecting the disciplining words of John. Everything that Gaius is, Diotrephes is not. Just opposite poles. John uses this negative example as an opportunity to encourage Gaius. Godly character and loyalty to the truth are never easy, but they bring God's richest commendation and John's also. The basic theme of this letter is the contrast between truth and servanthood of Gaius and Demetrius, the error, arrogance and selfishness of Diotrephes. You must have understood that there were three people here: Gaius, Demetrius, Diotrephes. Gaius and Demetrius are the good people, and Diotrephes is the selfish person. These three men bear positive and negative witness to proper relationships among Christian brethren who should be bonded by love. We find such people in all the churches. John is feeling sad about Diotrephes, whose heart was 180 degrees removed from Gaius. He no longer loves God. Moving through 3 John, five specific purposes can be discerned from its contents. First is to commend Gaius for his adherence to the truth and his hospitality to the emissaries sent out by John. We see this in verse 2. Second is to encourage Gaius to continue his support of the brethren, 6 to 8 verses. Third is to rebuke Diotrephes for his pride and misconduct, 9 to 11. Fourth is to provide recommendation for Demetrius. These two names are a little confusing because we are not familiar with those names. Fifth is to inform Gaius of John's intention to visit and straighten out the difficulties. This we see in 10th verse and 13th to 14th verse. Let's pray. Lord, help us to realize different personalities in the churches and help us to pray for people like Diotrephes. And also help us never to become like him, but instead follow Gaius. In Jesus' precious name I ask. Amen. Amen. God bless you.